As of April 28th of 2024, there are currently 49 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Indonesia's Ruang volcano, which produced the planet's most powerful explosive eruption in 12 months on April 17th. That eruption was Plinian in nature and devastated almost the entirety of the island it is on, along with causing stones thrown high into the air to punch holes through roofs on the adjacent Tagulandang island. The good news is Ruang does not appear capable of producing another powerful eruption for the short-term future, as the building pressure it had was released passively. Ruang's overall hazards have decreased, although it is still erupting via the growth of an andesitic lava dome on its summit, which was accompanied by a 200 to 500 meter high white plume. Due to decreasing activity, Ruang's alert level was decreased from 4 to 3 on April 22nd, but a 4 kilometer exclusion zone is still in place. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Tonga, a new volcanic eruption occurred at an unusual silica-rich primarily submarine volcano known as Lateiki. Sticking to Oceania and Vanuatu, the Ambrym volcano produced a new eruption this week, with satellite detecting the presence of fresh lava in its deep Marum crater. And, in what is this week's top story, the scenic volcano which produced the largest explosive volcanic eruption of the 2010s decade, Puyehue-Cordón, Caulle, had its alert level raised from green to yellow. This marks the first time that this Chilean volcano had its alert level increased to a non-baseline level since it produced a very low-end VEI-5 explosive eruption, the same order of magnitude as the 1980 eruption of Mount Saint Helens, which lasted from 2011 to 2012 and ejected 1.22 cubic kilometers of tephra. However, the most spectacular feat of that eruption was the emplacement of a rare phenomena, a 16 square kilometer near pure obsidian lava flow. Since April of last year, the refilling of Cordon Call's magma chamber had pushed up the ground at a rate of 6.5 centimeters a year. That was until November of 2023, when the rate of uplift increased, rising to 26.2 centimeters a year. This rate has potentially further increased during the last week, which occurred alongside other changes. Most notably, the number of volcano tectonic earthquakes increased, going from 4 a day to 15 a day. While this new unrest does not seem to mark a drastic and sudden short-term hazard, it does represent a longer-term hazard, meaning it could erupt later this year or next year. Luckily, the vast majority of eruptions Puyehue-Cordón, Caulle produces are 2 to 3 orders of magnitude smaller than its 2011 to 2012 eruption. Meanwhile, in Tonga, the dacitic stratovolcano, which rises a mere 140 feet above sea level known as Lateiki, produced a new eruption on April 19th. This latest eruption does not appear to be occurring above the water, but instead at shallow or intermediate depths in an effusive manner. The interaction of fresh molten rock and gases has turned nearby sections of the Pacific Ocean green, blue, and yellow. However, there is not a full guarantee that an eruption is ongoing, merely a likelihood of around 90%. Sometimes the exact same behavior can merely mark greatly increased fumarolic degassing, although I do not believe that to currently be the case. In Vanuatu, it appears that a lava lake has returned to the Ambrym volcano's Marum crater, the first time this has occurred since 2018. Ambrym is a pyroclastic shield volcano, meaning it has the shape of a shield, which is not only built by long-traveling low-viscosity lava flows, but also ash via incredibly voluminous explosive eruptions with a low eruption column height over a broad area. Ambrym has not produced a truly large explosive eruption since 1950, with most of its recent activity involving brief lava emplacement and the eruption of cinder cones. While Ambrym's latest activity could theoretically mark the beginning of a longer eruption within its broad caldera, activity does seem to be quite comparable to its brief 2022 and 2024 eruptions, which remained confined to a single small crater and lasted 9 and 4 days respectively. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on April 27th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my channel's supporters on Patreon and via YouTube members.